House, praise this name. Hallelujah. That's a message that I will do at some point. I didn't understand why Satan started pushing denominational names. As I studied John 17, Jesus said something incredible. He said, "Father, I have kept the disciples you've given me in your name." The disciples didn't know what he was talking about. He said, "I held them, except the son of perdition. I held them in your name." So when you hear praise his name, you're exalting the name that's keeping you, the name that's protecting you, the name that's delivering you. That's why you don't need anybody to tell you to praise the name. The secret source of your power, your breakthrough, the name by which you are called, Jesus. Yeah. Praise his name. Praise his name. Praise his name.
Raise his name.
That's why I look at anybody cross-eyed. When people get together, this one says, I'm a Christian. I'm a born-again believer. And then this one says, I'm Catholic. Oh, I'm Baptist. No. Those names were not given. The Bible said there's only one name given among men whereby we must be saved. The name. Hallelujah. The name. Jesus. The name. Hallelujah. Lord, we exalt that name this morning. Above our physical conditions, emotional conditions, spiritual conditions, we lift up the name of Jesus above every sickness and disease. Hallelujah, we lift up that name above every demonic force, every witchcraft, every power, every name that is named. Jesus Christ rules and reigns. Our resurrection house for all nations and around the world. And everybody that believes it and knows they shouted amen 3 times. Ooh, the shout of a king is in this house this morning. Hallelujah. Came to church. I've already received supernatural strength. Hallelujah. Oh, my miracle is in that name. My deliverance is in that name. Ooh, my power is in that name. My victory. Come on, at least 2 people or 3. Come on, slap them and tell them I celebrate the victory in that name. Hallelujah.
Hebrews chapter 10, for the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of the things, can never, with those sacrifices which they offered year by year continually, make the commas thereunto perfect. For then will they not have ceased to be offered, because that the worshippers once purged should have had no more conscience of sins. But in those sacrifices, there's a remembrance again made of sins
every year.
For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sin. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldst not, but a body hast thou prepared me. In burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin, thou hast had no pleasure. Then said I, lo, I come. In the volume of the book, it is written of me, to do thy will, O God. In other words, I come to do thy will, O God. Above, when he said, sacrifice and offering, and burnt offerings, an offering for sin, thou wouldst not, neither hadst pleasure therein, which are offered by the Lord. Then said he, lo, I come to do thy will, O God. He taketh away the first, that he may establish the second, by the which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. And every priest standard daily ministering and offering oftentimes the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down on the right hand of God, from henceforth expecting till his enemies be made his footstool. For by one offering he had perfected forever them that are sanctified. Whereof the Holy Ghost also is a witness to us. For after that he had said before, this is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their minds will I write them. And their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. Amen. Now, where remission of these is, there is no more offering for sin. Then it goes on and on. Father, thank you. We lift our hands in appreciation for the sacrifice that the Lord Jesus made on the cross. Thank you. We know that there are sins, struggles in different lives. But we thank you for your word this morning, that the price has already been paid. Hallelujah. And we believe you for grace to be poured on us this morning as we commune with you in the body and in the blood of the Lord Jesus. We celebrate victory this morning and thank you for all you have done. Quicken me physically, spiritually, and emotionally. And bless your sons and daughters and all those watching us on YouTube around the world. We give you praise for your face shining upon us this morning. Thank you for a great worship. Thank you for exalting your name among us. Thank you for every blessing that came out of that worship, that name, that praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you that your word will not fall to the ground. Hallelujah. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. I thought it was interesting when I came to church this morning and Elder Thomas came to open the service. and he prayed and read a scripture. And he started saying for us to thank God for perfecting all that concerns us. And I chuckled because when the Holy Spirit was unctioning me to make sure we receive communion this morning, and I asked him, so what should I talk about? He said, perfected in Christ.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I said, the Spirit is? The fight you and I have is that we're living our lives as if God has to still do something for you to overcome what is ailing you. It is so difficult to believe that the price has been paid.
Amen.
For me to overcome what is ailing me.
Amen.
Because the enemy is there making noise.
Yes.
My experiences are bearing a false witness. But I don't care what you are battling with or how many times you have fallen. This word says that by one offering, Jesus has perfected. Okay, look at what he said to me. He said, I didn't say that you get it all worked out and that you are perfect. He said, he perfected you. And until we start believing what he said, we will not see the victory.
Amen.
And he detailed the Old Testament sacrifice. He said, there's no way that you could be made perfect by those offerings made according to the law. Okay. Now watch. When I said that, immediately you think, well, I'm not in the Old Testament. I'm not killing any animals. But you don't know that the enemy we war against is a snake. And all he does is to talk you out of everything that's already yours. By postponing you receiving that you have the victory. He wants you to believe that when you have the victory is when you see something. He don't want you to accept that you have the victory now before you see something. All right, now watch. You were born just a few years ago. And one of the things that make some of you feel old is that you see people that you saw them when they were born, already married with kids. You remember them in diapers. But now, the way they're going, before long they will be grandparents.
Amen.
So the enemy wants you to start feeling old.
Yes.
And thinking old.
Yes.
And in America, people are running from their age.
Amen.
Not knowing that when you age, it's like a well-seasoned meal. That cooked slowly on the crock pot. That's why God said, now don't appoint a leader or a deacon or anybody who is a neophyte. He's zealous. He just got saved, but he hadn't been cooked yet.
Amen.
He hadn't been tried yet.
Amen.
Now watch. So age is not something you run from. Age is something you celebrate.
Amen.
The Bible says that the testament of God's favor on a land is that you see old men with hoary head walking around. Hallelujah.
Amen.
On our resurrection house, we have 10 times more reasons to praise him. But not only that we are getting older by the numbers, but we are getting younger in our spirit. And every time I walk through these doors, I don't see anybody limping. I don't see any oxygen tanks. I don't see any crutches. Youth.
know what? So we were born a few years ago, even if you are 90. But Jesus paid for your sins.
Yes.
2,000 years ago.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
The fact that it was paid for long ago didn't stop you from getting saved. Amen. Then why in the world would you get saved and don't believe anything else? When he paid for your sin, he paid for your deliverance. He paid for your healing. What we are missing is the faith power to receive. And we all fall into it where you are looking at the data. But it's Satan's data that you're looking at. He said that once for all, he perfected them. The belief. Wow. And then when you look at your life, you say, well, fooled me. Because I know about 10 things that are wrong with me right now. Yeah, but that's your take. That's the reason, he says, there is no way anybody that operates by the law can ever be perfected. He said, why? Because there's a remembrance of sin. That's why when you get up to exercise faith, Satan will remind you of this and then remind you of that. And I don't know why you are running from what he's reminding you. You agree with him.
Amen.
Yeah, you're right. But he perfected me. Yes, I'm guilty, but he forgave me. Hallelujah. He said there's no remembrance of sin. He said that he washed it away. He said, now in the old covenant, you can't be perfect because your conscience is always accusing you. And when he says, if you receive this unworthily, you drink damnation to yourself. Meaning if you come to it and you don't believe that this has settled your score with God, you're going to take this thing and he's going to kill you instead of blessing you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
But this morning you should start thanking him, Lord, that you have perfected me. I know I'm struggling over here, but I believe that you paid for it. There's no need for any further sacrifice.
Beloved, it's a powerful message for you this week. Everything has been paid for. It's such an exciting word to me. It changed and reconfigured my faith. For years I was praying and believing God for what he will do. I didn't know he has already done it. Everything was paid for. I'm yet to speak about this in the sanctuary, talking about the body of Christ. In our communion services, we're looking now at his body, and then we'll go to his blood. All these things made provisions in our redemption. And one of the things that I see that's lacking in the church, in Christendom as a whole, is this blessing that has been left on the table all these years. He said the chastisement of our peace was upon him. You notice, was upon him. And yet people are going crazy. People need medications. People, hey, he says, I mean, I have had times when so much was on my mind and I didn't have peace, or this happened and took my peace. But he said he paid for me to get my peace back. We've left so much on the table. You will hear the message when he comes. But he paid for it. It's finished. It is finished. But we come and receive salvation freely. Boom, the miracle happens. A dead human spirit is reborn. And we can contact God. But after that, we can't seem to get our faith together to receive healing, to receive financial blessing and breakthrough, to break curses. Now we need somebody to help us. No, he says, you are complete in him who is the head of all principality and power. That's one of the blessings I celebrate in my life, and I'm self-contained in my God. There's hardly anything you can point to that has come from outside of me. It's all been within the framework of my personal relationship and communion with God. That's the seat of my faith and confidence. That even when I'm going into demon-possessed territories,
dangerous zones, I have my faith in God. They might be waiting for me, but I walked through that checkpoint. They wouldn't even know it's me. I remember in John F. Kennedy in New York, JFK. And when I got to the lady to verify my documents, she said, "Who are you?" I said, "What do you mean?" She said, "I saw you in the line, and I saw all the people. And then when he got to you, there was this light on you, and he's just tracking with you. I knew you were different from everybody in this place. It's the glory resting upon me." I explained it to her. She said, "Oh, I'm glad that I encountered you today." I said, "Receive the blessing." It would have been interesting if she fell out there. Well, I'm out of time. But you are perfected in him. Stop running from pillar to post, looking for what you already have. Listen to this word this week, and may it change your life in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.